Welcome back to the MLS Show. We are going to be discussing New York Red Bulls against Seattle in this one. Red Bulls, lads, they have turned it round at a shocking start to the season. Nobody panicked. Probably a few people did. But they've turned it round quite brilliantly now and are now in second place in the Eastern Conference. Won this one by 2-0. No goals for Bradley Wright Phillips, which is a bit of a bummer for me because I had them down to get a brace. But yeah, a 2-0 win, and the good form continues.
Grella was the man, wasn't he? I mean, was it the first one with the little chip finish?
The second.
That is a beautiful finish.
Like, a great goal.
Absolutely brilliant.
He was Johnny on the spot for the first one. Kleshtan hits a post with a wonderful curl.
Oh, yeah, it was just a rebound, wasn't it?
But he's come up with some goals this year.
Grella's proper, he's a proper instrumental player, isn't he?
Not often talked about, is he?
Fans love him, don't they? Fans really love him. He's one of those, like, everyone has them at the team, don't they? Very dependable, little, cult hero at the club. And in the absence of, DPs, really, really, like, big name DPs, you look over the park, and you've got,
get the binoculars.
There's a river and all there's kinds in between. And wise guys and everything, Sopranos and everything in between. Do you see three top players? Where New York, for the last couple of seasons, have been grinding out results, without those big names. But I still think they need to bring in someone.
Yeah.
Because the last few seasons have been falling down in the playoffs, and maybe that extra little bit of talent is what will get them over the line. But they do really, when they get their heads down, they do go on these good runs, and they always look like a top side.
I think you've got Bradley Wright Phillips in there. You've always got a goal scorer, haven't you? He's always going to get on the end of things. They've got Sasha Kleshtan, fantastic. Grella, like we've said, Philippe in midfield.
Kovar looked all right as well.
So they've got the players there. They are workmanlike. It's like we were talking about with Philadelphia Union before, without having those. I mean, Philadelphia Union are very similar. They haven't got anyone. Barnett is their biggest name, probably. Red Bulls, they have had a couple of them, haven't they? They've had Thierry Henry in the past. They've had Tim Cahill, of course. Is that what you think it is? Just that extra little bit?
What New York are very good at is they book the trend for me in MLS because they're very organised.
Yeah.
Really organised. Solid at the back. Play with the two holding centre midfielders and let everyone else in front of them work off that. But I just wonder if a little bit more sprinkling of magic would push them on. Of course, they need better players because they haven't won the title. They do need a little bit of extra. But it's got to be extra that fits in with the system. And maybe that's what they haven't quite had in the last few years. When they brought in like the likes of Tim Cahill, yes, in his second season he was scoring a lot of goals, but did he necessarily help the system? Did he move it on anymore?
So I think what you're saying is, you need someone who's going to work just as hard as everybody else.
Yeah.
And there are players out there, there are big time players who do work really hard. I mean, one of the ones, and he's not probably the type of player that you're talking about, but they're Cal for us.
Yeah.
Worked so hard going into a league like MLS at his prime, he would have worked really well.
Brilliant.
I think there's other players like, and he's getting a lot of stick at the moment. Raheem Sterling, when he played for us, worked really, really hard and bought into that high pressing type of thing. There will be potential DPs out there who are willing to work hard, who aren't just the Lukaku type of striker or whatever.
But it's weird they did have Henry, they did have Cahill, they've had Janino, had these kind of players, they've had big, and maybe that scared them off a little bit. I'm not 100% sure. Some of those names maybe have scared them off. I know one particular Mexican who really didn't like.
Yeah. He scored as well the other week.
Because of his sort of attitude to working hard.
Yeah.
So it'd be interesting, but it's New York, isn't it? I know they don't strictly play in New York, but the idea of going to live in New York as a player, that's got a lot of attractions, hasn't it? You think about it.
Obviously, they were up against Seattle. It was Siggy Smith's 500th game. The other,
I think that's about 100 too many.
That's another thing. But I think the thing, obviously, Seattle missing Clint Dempsey, he's such a key figure for them. Jordan Morris, the young lad's come in and done really well this season. But without Dempsey.
Well, remember this time last year when well, it was a little bit around this time when Dempsey was out with suspension and Obafemi Martins was out, and the wheels just completely
because they were flying.
Oh, they were amazing, and that partnership was just amazing.
Yeah,
it was the best partnership in MLS.
Yeah,
and the wheels just completely fell off. So, and you know they've not replaced Obafemi Martins.
That's, I mean,
no one matter what anyone says.
Yeah, I mean Jordan Morris has done. I think he's got 4 goals, but he's a young lad. Evertonian as well. He's a young lad, and he's come in this season. But he's not. Obafemi Martins was in that league in particular. Listen, he was just goals.
It's not all about goals, is it? At the end of the
well, it is. But he's got to be
four. It's not all about goals. It's not all about goals. Obafemi Martins had. He had a link up with Dempsey.
Well,
he had pace and he had a lovely link up, and they were both scoring goals, he's got all the experience and he knew how to use his head and knew how to use his head to go and get a like £5 million deal in China as well. So
just quickly then, Seattle changed the manager.
They should have changed the manager in the off season. They should have changed him in the off season. Listen. He wears nice scarves, that's about it. He's done. They need a fresh approach. And Seattle have got everything. They've got the stadium. They've got some of the best fans in MLS. They've got a brilliant sort of setup in terms of the teams they play, you know, locally, like Portland and Vancouver. It's set up, and they've obviously got a bit of money behind them as well, Microsoft and stuff, so... I just think they should have changed the manager up and just took some radical. Because what we've seen the last couple of years is some teams just going, you know what, something's got to change.
Mm.
Columbus Crew did it. The Rapids look like they did it. Toronto did it to some success.
Mm.
Some teams have just gone, we need to just kick on and start again. Yeah. And the fact that Portland won MLS Cup, that should have been... the impetus to say we need to start again here, lads, because what we're doing is we're just drifting.
Teams you've mentioned over and just then, obviously Portland Timbers, they drew 2-2 at Real Salt Lake the other night. Good result for them. Houston Dynamo have changed their manager. Owen Coyle has somehow got a job at Blackburn Rovers since leaving Houston. We don't know whether he probably was tapped up by Blackburn when he was over there, hence the thing. Houston have had a couple of draws since Bill Hammett stopped them getting a win the other night.
Yeah.
He made a couple of marvellous saves. But just quickly on Owen Coyle, have you ever rated him, Chris? You've seen his work in England.
Look, he's had, as far as I can remember, one really good season. Other than that, I don't know.
Do you remember, Chris, when Owen Coyle was touted as being Arsene Wenger's successor? How ridiculous does that sound now?
In the week when Arsene Wenger is now rumoured to be getting a 2-year contract extension, by the way.
I knew that he would be.
But how ridiculous is that, though?
Not Arsene getting another
People
two
were talking years. About him now as being Arsene Wenger's successor because he had a nice little spell at Bolton and he was playing sort of like this hybrid football and everyone was loving it, and look at him now. He's gone to Blackburn to pull his socks over his
knees. For me, he was always more of a manager who's very good at talking the talk.
Mm.
I never really had the stuff to back it up.
He'll be gutted though, won't he? Because it's not called the Barclays Premier League anymore. It's just called the Premier League now. So he won't even be able to go, Trinity back in the Premier Barclays.
He won't know what he's saying. Because he used to love Major League Soccer. That's what he'd say, Major League Soccer. Everything was Major League Soccer. Houston, I mean, they're another one. They need a centre forward. We've said this before.
Giles Barnes has been
Barnes, Will Bruin gets on the end. For me, they're still shy of a really good centre forward.
Never replace Brian Ching.
This was the man.
Never replace Brian Ching.
He should get
the legendised
Brian.
Him back the man who went on strike.
Who was he like?
Oh, Brian Ching, man. He was just amazing.
If he brought him back and bought Mark Kerr. They'd have had Kerr.
This was the man that basically went on strike because he got traded.
Yeah.
And he was like, no, I'm not going anywhere. And they were like, no, you're not. He was like, no, I'm not. I'll retire if you trade me. So
and he did.
No, he kept them. They put him on the list. No, end the season basically the agents list, and someone took an option on him, and he just went, I'm not going. Basically, I'll retire before I leave Houston, and
there you go.
Yeah,
that's right. Brilliant.
It's a great World Cup, Brian
Ching. It's a great MLS story.
2002 World Cup.
Let's move on.
Listen, at least we're showing we're not just jumping on the bandwagon, are we? We've been here.
That's brilliant. But I'm just saying, we'll do a Ching appreciation show. Colorado Rapids kept their good form going. They beat Chicago Fire.
Can we just one second? Can we just go back to Bill Hammond?
Oh, Bill. Yeah.
Oh, he's amazing.
Bill Hammond.
I want Everton to sign Bill Hammond. He's amazing. That's saving the last minute.
Two. He made the save.
What's your thoughts? Sure of written
it
down.
Chris, Bill Hammond. Who was it? Manatus, was it? It was a great strike.
Nicky Minaj?
Not Nicky Minaj and not Michael Madar. Manatus drives on in. Stay there. Hammond makes the save. They get a corner. Corner comes in. Bullet header. He saves it again.
What type of header?
Bullet header, Chris. Love it.
From Nicky Minaj?
From Nicky Minaj. Absolutely.
Bill Hammond, amazing. I want him at Everton.
All right. Bill Hammond. Listen.
So that in 10 years' time I can slag him off.
There you go. Cheers, Aubrey's waving. Let's carry on.
Where is Tim Howard coming?
Colorado Rapids. Talking to Tim Howard. They beat Chicago Fire 2-1. Kevin Doyle. He's back.
Kevin Doyle.
Opened the score.
Ireland's loss. It is Colorado Rapids' game.
Ireland spanked at the weekend by Belgium. Kevin Doyle.
If Kevin Doyle had been there, he would have marked Lukaku to the game and scored. That's how good Kevin Doyle is.
Doyle opened the score.
How's his gash, by the way?
His gash is all right.
Question for you too. How has the copper in the Euros affected it, like across the league?
Well, it stopped for a couple of weeks while the copper was on. It's still going
Copper's
on. It's
still on.
But I mean, the main. They always stop for the semis now. So they've come in. But obviously, the European, the Euros.
There's not a lot of players in the Euros.
Not that many. Seaman, who's playing for, not David, Seaman, who's playing for Belgium, is obviously away with it and a couple of others. But
Robbie Keane.
You know, Robbie Keane, who
doesn't get played
for Ireland. Galaxy didn't mind him. But anyway, Colorado, Marco Pape, that man again, a late winner to keep Colorado flying at the top there. Columbus Crew, 0. Montreal Impact, 0. This game was absolutely
non-MLS. Non-MLS.
How many 0-0 draws are there?
Well, there was two at the weekend.
But, across the season, roughly, as a percentage, are they a lot lower than European League?
So, yeah. Definitely. There is, but we've had a couple this weekend, unbelievably. New England Revolution won at Vancouver. Kai Kamara at the mare still hasn't scored a goal, which is unbelievable.
Too busy arguing.
But it's But the game going to finish with was Toronto beating LA Galaxy by a single goal. Ped, Galaxy missing Keane, as you just said. And a couple of others.
Gerrard missing. Was he missing? Was he still in Liverpool?
Oh, I'm not saying.
He's injured, apparently.
Well, I've seen pictures of him.
He's injured.
I've seen pictures of him.
He's injured. Photoshop. Dos Santos.
I've seen a green screen.
I mean, I don't know whether this is true or not, but I heard there's rumours of him that he was in France with a gum shield in his mouth. I'm not seeing anything else.
Dos Santos missing as well. And, you know, LA went down to a Toronto goal that wasn't scored or created by Giovinco.
Who should be in the Euros. Because he's amazing.
He's amazing.
Is that the first one?
It was last week. The last time he played for the break was the first time he'd scored, and Giovinco wasn't part of it, which is
the guy's the last incredible.
The last time anyone scored, that wasn't him. It was Danny Dicchio.
Danny, what a player! He was amazing.
They love him. They still clap him. They still clap the minute of
Danny
his number.
Danny Dicchio, he's amazing. But Drew Moore got the winner with a diving header. But Toronto, the first eight games are away from home. They've had a few at home now since they've done the stadium. BMO stadiums being changed.
Doesn't look any different.
Well,
it's got a roof on it.
That's a big difference.
It is a big
difference. That's a fucking huge difference, and I'm sorry.
If you're listening to the podcast, which apparently there's going to be one now, Pet's going to show them to do it. Sorry, if you're watching, look who's
it. It's a big difference, though. Come on.
We'll cut that.
Well, there's a roof on three sides of it.
Yeah. Who builds a stadium in Toronto with no roof? Seriously, isn't that just the question we should ask?
Look, I can go back to Minnesota Vikings. Their stadium had a roof in Minnesota. Snow landed on it. The roof caved in because there was that much snow.
That happened in Vancouver, didn't it? No? The stadium got a big bulge in it because of the snow.
Well, Minnesota's went woomph, and then they've
What was it made out of?
I'd guess metal. I don't know.
It wasn't Steel.
But it was, what, a year, 2 years ago?
Yeah.
And it came through, and they've moved stadiums now. Like, so sometimes it's not a bad idea. If you've not got the building material set, have a load of snow on the top. Sometimes
do you think it was an insurance job?
I think it could have been an inside.
Let's say, yeah. So anyway, Galaxy lost.
Yeah, one of those, like, snow lamp
Galaxy
things.
Are in fifth place. Aubrey, you know. Galaxy are in fifth yeah. place at the moment.
Galaxy are...
But they're just...
In a perfect position. Yeah, they won't care. Bruce Arena won't care. No. He'll be looking and go, we'll kick in. We'll get all
after
our...
the hump.
We'll get all our lads back. Well, you know, he won't be bothered one bit.
I mean, even in this game, Sebastian Leggett had a couple of really, really good chances to, you know, when it was 0-0.
They've got quality. But it's about balancing it out, and yeah. they won't be that bothered. They'll be looking for the road in. This is all background noise at the moment.
Till the hump. We're trying to make videos and keep it going, so there you go.
Well, we've got Chris here to add the swears.
Exactly, Chris, bringing the levels down. See you, Red. So, yeah, so that's the end of it.
That's ruined it. I don't even know if we're still
it's
making
off
videos.
Off camera.
I still don't even make
videos. Ed Sheeran's literally just walked basically, out. Whatever camera I'm on.
Basically, someone ginger has just walked
no,
out.
No, it's not. It was actual.
It does look like Ed Sheeran.
Well, the fact that he came down with a ballet dancer and Taylor Swift was running after him out there, I thought it. Anyway, let us know on anything.
I didn't even say hello to the guy.
Yeah, when I come in.
No, what did you say hello to Ed and buy it?
I walked in and he went, when your legs don't move like they used to. You know, something like started kissing me. So there you go. Anyway, make sure on the tee. He thought it was Taylor Swift. Let's move on very quickly. It's gone.
Is that Ped's drinking. Always dressing up as a girl?
Every week. We're going. Thanks, Aubrey, for letting me know how long I'll cut it up. Don't forget to leave your comments on anything below, including was Steven Gerrard really in Liverpool? Can Toronto's roof withstand snow?
And did Ed Sheeran, in fact, enter the studio.
Does Ed Sheeran do the
end? And Chris Barry on the cheek.
He exited the studio, actually. He'd entered it a lot
earlier. There's Loki.
And
I looked.
Is it where?
This is the end of the show. We will see you next time on the MLS Show.